Hey guys, what's going on? After getting crushed by the Fate Weaver Dream 2 days ago, we are now also playing an Assassin Prophecy deck. As you can see in the decklist, the deck consists of nearly 50% of the cards are Prophecy cards. So you have a very high chance to hit some Prophecy cards when opponents are breaking the runes. Now let's start here with the Daring Catpurse and the House Kinsman against an Archer. Strategy of the deck is quite simple. You are hitting your opponent as much as possible, and then if he is going into your runes and into your face, you can punish him a lot. Also lots of direct damage like the Ransack, Crushing Blow, Lightning Bolts. There's a Daring Catburst. We are also playing our Daring Catburst on the white lane. And a Fighter's Guild recruit. So the Warcrafter is fine for that. Let's drop it. Killing the Fighter's Guild recruit. The Daring Catburst is still without any damage, so he's not going down.
This one offers something tasty.
Racketeer, another lethal minion, pushing more damage, and we're getting a Prophecy. There's a Fate Weaver. Let's drop that here on the left side and getting a Bootlash Lander. So it is okay to get some damage because you're just punishing your opponent. So let's hit the face. Going down to 23, no Prophecy there. Will most likely kill the Catbird with this Guma here. And we will play some stuff on the left side now. Brutal Ashlander looks fine. We can either play the Daggerfall Mage or the House Kinsman. Right now I like the Daggerfall Mage a bit more. Rapid Shot. We are getting the Tomb of Alteration. Clearing the shield. There's a Crushing Blow. And he will go for the face again with the Catbird. That's okay. That's definitely okay. So using the Bootlash Lander here, hopefully hitting the Catbird. So that's the case. So we can use the Daggerfall Mage to take it out. And let's hit him for another 3. There is a Prophecy. Fighter's Guild recruit, so he will take out the Fate Weaver. Then let's use the Cliff Razor for another 4 damage, so he is down to 16. So what's your plan? Depending on his play, we are either playing double House Kinsman, we are playing one House Kinsman with a Black Zap Protector, or we are playing the Ransack. For example, if he is dropping the Moonlight Werbert, you want to kill that with the Ransack, not give him any life. Otherwise the double House Kinsman looks pretty strong. We are pushing another 4 into his face, so he will be at 12 and the House Kinsman will deal another 6 at least. So down to 6 then. And there is a Cliff Razor. Taking out the other Cliff Razor. And we have a Moonlight Werbert, but we are dropping the double House Kinsman here. Looks like the best play.
Follow me, men.
That's the Bannerman. And a rapid shot on one of the Hoskins men is drawing another card. So with the Bannerman, he can get two Nord Firebrands whenever he's attacking. Let's start with the attack here first. Push him down to 10. We are still in 21. So the Nord Firebrands right now are not too dangerous. He can push us for 4, break another rune, so we might get another minion. That's why we are just dropping the Black Set Protector and the Moonlight Werebat on the right. And it should be enough to finish the game here.
Let's heat things up.
Garven Pyromancer. And to finish off, killing the Moonlight Werebat. Workwater Witch. So clearing the Hoskins man, dealing 3 damage. Still breaking the rune and we might get a prophecy. There's a crushing blow. Nord Firebrand number 1, Nord Firebrand number 2. Clearing the protector. But still. We have the Ransack, we have the crushing blow. And we will use the Tomb of Alteration here on the Hoskins man. Drawing another card, there's a Fighter's Guild Recruit. Then let's use the Crushing Blow to take out the Murkwater Witch. Push 5 damage, he's down to 2. Getting no help from a Prophecy. And next turn, he's getting damage from the Hoskins man. We have the Ransack here for 3 damage. Looks fine. So the Giant will get the Hoskins man back into the hand, but he is still losing the game.
I'll kill you where you stand.
Also the Shrieking Harpy, that's even enough to kill him. Rapid shot.
Is yours.
Oh, there's a concede and we win the game. Second game, Assassin versus the Sorcerer. We need to replace all cards and let's hope for some cheap ones. You always want to start with the Brutal Ashlander. No, that's not better. Double Ransack on the starting hand. In fact, that's pretty bad. Let's hope that the Sorcerer is not going too aggressive here. Lightning Bolt, another card we don't want to draw here early on. Also reducing the chance to get some decent face damage out of the wounds. There's a Hist Grove. So it looks like a Ramp Sorcerer. We are starting with the Daggerfall Mage. There comes the Harpy and the Windkeep Spell Sword. So we will drop the Black Zap Protector. He will run into it with the Windkeep Spell Sword and we can then kill it with the Daggerfall Mage.
You must be cleansed.
Oh, the Shadowfin Priest silencing the Mage. Should we just go to the face here? That's possible. Let's hit him for 3 and play the Royal Sage.
I see you're in need of my wisdom.
Getting a breakthrough ward and another breakthrough. Let's break the first rune. Ward is pretty decent on the protector.
harmed you?
Mother of mine!
For 7, he is playing the Nahag Leaf. Can't deal with that at the moment.
There are ill winds this
so let's move the minion here.
You can't escape.
Kill the Harpy. Also drop the Wardcrafter. Another harpy, juggling the royal sage, reminder, and the highborg summoner. So lots of low cost cards. Oh, interesting enough, he was not attacking with the Nahag Leaf. Getting the Fate Weaver, drop that here, and the Cliff Racer. Break another rune, and there comes the Black Zap Protector as well.
The forest is my strength and my courage.
So with the Cliff Racer and the Black Zap Protector, we are good enough to take out the Nahag Leaf.
Your blood will spill.
Teach you to mess with me.
Then let's hit him for 3 in the face. Down to 19, and we are dropping. Let's see, we have quite some base damage here already with 4. Better to drop the Cat Purse now. He will kill the Dune Smuggler here with the High Rock Summoner.
I am a child of
Night Shadow. And the Flame Atomash. So I would say change of plans. Let's use the Ransack here on the Flame One. We are clearing the Shadowfin Priest with the Cat Purse, and let's drop the Fighter's Little Good. And he's down to 11. We will get some life back from the Night Shadow. So that will push him back to 17. If he's clearing the Fighter's Guild Recruit without a... Oh, he's going down, okay. There's a Shrieking Harpy. Let's use it on the Blood Magic Lord. Then we are dropping the Lightning Bolt here. Taking out the Blood Magic Lord.
You can't escape.
Let's hit him for 8. And also drop the House Kinsman.
They cannot hope to outwit me.
With the Tezcat and another 6 into his face, that should be enough now. Ooh, drain life. Giving us another prophecy. We're down to 5. Can he kill us here? Lightning bolt, or crushing blow, that's enough.
Elements, I summon
Supreme Atomancer, that is not enough to kill us. We still have 1 life, and we have exactly lethal on the board. So even without the Tezcat, we should win the game. Let's see.
Teach you to mess with me.
Hopefully don't have a lightning bolt, but that doesn't matter because we are just attacking with the task guard here and hitting for 6. Otherwise the lightning bolt could finish the game for us. Just hit us here for 4. And that's the conclusion of today's episode. Thank you for watching. If you like my content and want to see more of it, check out my other stuff on the channel or simply hit the thumbnails in the end card you are seeing right now. You can always reach out to me in the comments with feedback or deck requests, so don't be shy. Last but not least, if you want to support me, you can do so in various ways. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on Twitter and Twitch, or use my affiliate partners, which can be found in the description box below the video. It will allow me to keep the channel and new content coming in on a regular basis. Until then, see you in my next video and goodbye.